Hey there. Okay, so today we're going to talk about adding and subtracting with signed numbers. And this is one of those things that if you learned it in school, you probably learned it one way, and there's more than one way to do it. And it's really frustrating because they don't tell you that. So with me today, because there's more than one way to do this, I have invited my friend Connie along. So here's me. I'm going to be the blue pen. And then my friend Connie's here. She's going to be the red pen. And the reason I had her come and be a part of this video is because she does it in a completely different way than I do. And it makes sense for her head, but it doesn't make sense for my head. And I wanted her to explain it really well. So the first problem that we have here as an example is negative 10 plus a negative 7. And when I'm doing a problem like this, where I'm looking, I have two negative numbers and I'm going to add them together, I always think about it as part of a number line. So let me get my little number line up here so you can see it. Now the numbers are really, really tiny. But this, it goes from negative 20 to positive 20, and 0 is right here in the center. And so let me walk you through how I do this. So I would start at negative 10, which is right there. And then I'm going to add to that a negative 7. So this is like my negative side. This is my positive side. And even though I have an add right here, this is the guy that's going to affect my movement and the direction that I go. So I'm going to go in the negative direction here. So I'm going to move to the left 7 places. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And so I end up with my answer of negative 17, because that's the spot that I landed on when I counted in the negative direction 7 places. So that's the number line way to do everything. Let me grab my little eraser here so that Connie can tell you how she thinks about these.
Okay. I do these in a completely different way. I see these parentheses and I don't like them, so I get rid of them first.
Okay, so we're just gonna erase those. Okay,
And where we've got a plus and a minus, the minus always wins. So it becomes negative 10 minus 7. And anytime you have two negative numbers that you're putting together, I don't even call it adding and subtracting, I call it putting together, you add the numbers together. So we have 10 and 7. We add those together in 17. Now we pick the sign. It's whatever the sign was to start with.
So that if they both have a negative, then the answer is going to have a negative.
Yes.
Okay. Cool. Okay, let's look at another example here. And again, we'll do it both ways. So here we have negative 15 plus 7. So again, let me get my next little number line thing here. I would look at it at, so here's my 0 again. So this is my negative side. This is my positive side. I'm going to start at negative 15, which is clear down here. And I'm going to add, so I'm going to move in the positive direction 7 places. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And so that means that I land on negative 8. That's my answer, is to land on negative 8. Okay, so now, Connie, how would you solve that?
Okay, now, this one doesn't have parentheses, but I have a negative 15 and a positive 7. I'm going to put these together. The signs are different, so I subtract the numbers.
So you find the difference between these two numbers because the signs are different, okay.
And the difference is 8, and because the 15 is the bigger number, it wins out, its sign comes in. And we have negative 8.
Okay. Wow, okay. Here's another example. This is a positive 18 minus a positive 7. So again, I would think about this as with a number line. If I'd been really organized, I would have drawn the 0 and the negative and the positive on all of these pieces of paper before I started the video, right? Okay, so I'm going to start over here at positive 18. And even though it says that this is a positive, I'm subtracting. So I'm still going to be moving in this direction. So I'm going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And I'm going to end on 11, or positive 11, however you want to think about that. So that's how I find my answer. Let me erase this. Connie, how would you solve this?
Okay. First thing I would do is get rid of the parentheses, but I'd look at these first because they're different. It's a subtraction, so it's 18 minus 7. That looks really familiar. That's what we've done all our lives.
Let me write this here in your red pen so that we can see it.
And so 18 minus 7 is 11. And because the 18 is bigger, it's a positive.
So even though, that's a good way to look at it, because even though it has this mess of stuff in the middle, it still is like a problem that we've done forever. That's confusing. Why would they do that to us? They're so mean.